This tutorial shows how to change the default font in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a technical writer and editor who shares step-by-step software tutorials and writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Today's tutorial shows how to change the default font for body text in Microsoft Word. Afterwards, we'll look at how to restore Word's original defaults by replacing the normal template file through the Windows File Explorer. We'll look at how to change the default fonts for all 9 heading levels in a separate tutorial. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365 and the Windows 10 File Explorer. These steps will also work in Word 2019, Word 2016, and Word 2013. However, your interface might look slightly different in those older versions of the software. These steps don't apply to Word for Mac. Please note that these steps may not work if you're using Word through work or school because you need permission to change the normal template file. The following steps show how to change the default font, font size, and font color for regular body text styled as normal. However, please be aware that other styles that rely on the normal style may also be affected. To begin, select the Home tab in the ribbon. Then select the Dialog Box Launcher in the Font group. When the font dialog box appears, select your new font, font size, and font color. After making your choices, select the Set as Default button. And then select the All Documents Based on the Normal.m Template option in the Question dialog box, followed by the OK button. Your existing body text should change to your new default font immediately. And your new default should appear when you open a new Word document. Your default font choices are stored in the normal template file. If you want to restore Word's default font styles, you can delete the existing normal file. Word will then create a new normal file the next time you open the software. The location of my normal file will be the same for most Windows users. However, there is a chance that your file will be located elsewhere. We'll be moving through several layers of folders within the File Explorer. Please note that I've created a companion blog post showing all the steps with images, so you don't have to worry about writing down the order of the different folders. The blog post is linked in the description box below. Before completing these steps, also note that this process will delete any existing custom themes. To begin, save any open documents and close Word. Then press the Windows key plus E on your keyboard to open the File Explorer. Alternatively, you can search for File Explorer in the search box in the taskbar. When the File Explorer opens, select the Windows C drive in the pane on the left side. Then select the Users folder. Within the Users folder, select your username folder. For example, my username is Erin. Then select the View tab. And select the Hidden Items option if it's not already selected. This will reveal folders that were previously hidden. Now select App Data, followed by Roaming. Within the Roaming folder, select Microsoft, and then select Templates. Next, select the normal.m file, and then select the delete key on your keyboard. Or you can right-click the file and select delete from the shortcut menu. Finally, select the X to close the File Explorer. When you reopen Word, the original defaults should be restored. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to insert and modify images in Microsoft Word, and how to change the style of hyperlinks in Microsoft Word. Please see the complete list in the playlist titled How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erin.writewriting.com, which is also linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word, Adobe Acrobat, or Google Docs that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.